Hello YouTube, so today we're going to be learning how to tie the cord onto the baton, okay? So let me start off by saying, yes, my cord is old. It's so old that I did end up losing a tassel, so I only have one tassel, okay? But for today's video, I think it's going to be very necessary and it'll be very helpful. So my baton is not your typical normal baton, it's one of the shorter ones. I have one of the shorter batons. You're going to always start off by cleaning your baton. I have already cleaned mine before we started this video. So you're going to clean your baton first, okay? So this right here, this from here, can you see that? From here on down, it's called the shaft. So the shaft is what we're going to focus on today. Let's begin with the cord. You're going to get the cord all straightened out and everything. Now what you want to do is, for this video, we're going to use the tassel side because I only have one tassel. So you're going to make one length longer, significantly longer. I'm going to make it significantly longer than the other side. So you see here, we have a pretty big gap in between. Pretty big gap, that's gonna be important. So about arm's length apart. So you see, whole arm's length apart. That's where we want it, okay? And we're left with about this much left, okay? Half of my arms. We're left with that much, okay? So once we pinch this, we're gonna make a loop right here, okay? Make a loop. Don't lose that spot. Put it in between the baton onto the shaft, okay? We're gonna bring it up about right about there, okay? Pinch it down, and the longer end, you're gonna wrap the long end around the short end 13 times. So, there we go. Make sure you're pulling it tight, one, two, 13 times. So once you have that wrapped 13 times, now here comes the fun part. You're going to do a crisscross. So remember the position of the baton so you can see it? You're going to crisscross. So just like this, crisscross it. Just like that. Okay? You're going to crisscross just like that. And make sure that it's tight. And you're gonna do it about 5 times. Just like we did up here, we're gonna wrap it again down here, except we're not gonna do it 13 times up here. We're not gonna do it 13 times down here like we did up here. This time we're gonna do it about 6 times. So we're gonna wrap it 6 times. Here we go. And make sure it's tight, just like we did up front. Now this part, you can keep wrapping it, and you can stop here if you want to. But my goal is to make sure that these two are equal length. So I'm gonna keep wrapping until this is equal with this. Right now I'm at 6. So I'm gonna keep wrapping until we're equal. Did about 9 times, so I'm gonna stop there. And then just like we did for this part, we're going to crisscross it. So we're gonna finish crisscross. Back it one more time. Careful not to pull the tassels. Now we're gonna tie it up. Right. One double knot of each one. Pull it tight. And now just run your fingers on it like that to stretch it out, make sure it's nice and steady. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how I tie my baton cord.